Hello students, this is Kesarkar and I have come with another video about the first chapter. Okay, this is look the chart first. This is the first chapter of your textbook, that is Operating System and Graphical User Interface. Okay, and I will discuss the function of operating system. I have divided the functions of operating system into three different videos, and I will discuss here only the first function, that is starting the computer. I have posted another video earlier, but I have said two things wrong in that video. That is the full form of BIOS. The full form of BIOS is basic input output system, and I said the full form of BIOS is basic input output device. It is BIOS, last one is S, so basic input output system. Another thing I said wrong, that is the boot sector loads the operating system, but the boot sector does not load the operating system, the boot loader loads the operating system. Okay, these two things I said in hurry, I said wrong in hurry, so I am discussing it again. Okay, first look the function of operating system. There are six functions given in your textbook. These are starting the computer, process management, hardware resource management, software resource management, managing files and folders, and memory management. Okay, so I will discuss here the first one, starting the computer. Operating system helps in starting the computer. Okay, so you know what is operating system. Operating system is the system software that acts as an intermediary between the computer hardware and the computer user. Okay, so I told you that operating system is the backbone of software system in computer. If you have to run any software in computer, you have to install the operating system. Every software need operating system to work properly or to run properly. Okay, so in computer system, operating system is the backbone software. That's why operating system is known as the system software. Okay, so first you have to know how operating system helps in starting up the computer. Look, step one, power button is turned on. So at first you have to turn on the power button. Okay, then what happens? The controls goes to BIOS. The full form of BIOS is basic input output system residing on ROM. ROM, what is ROM? Read only memory. You know that the content of ROM does not go if the power is turned off. Okay, it is permanent. The content of ROM is permanent, and BIOS resides on ROM. Okay, so BIOS is one type of program, that is a very very fast program on the when you turned on the computer. When you turned on the power button, the control goes to BIOS. Then what BIOS does? BIOS check that if every input output device are working properly or not, and they are able to do the work or not. That is power on self test. It is known as power on self test or POST. Okay, then if BIOS finds that everything is okay, then BIOS sends the control to the bootloader. Bootloader finds out boot sector on the disk. In the hard disk, there is a boot sector. That means where the operating system is stored in the hard disk. Basically, we store operating system in the C drive of computer. In general, we store the operating system in the C drive of the hard disk. Okay, so boot sector, the purpose of bootloader. What is the purpose of bootloader? Bootloader loads the operating system from hard disk to RAM, that is from hard disk to computer's memory. So after BIOS, the control goes to bootloader. Bootloader is also a program, and bootloader tries to find out the boot sector in the hard disk. Okay, when it finds the boot sector in the hard disk, it finally load the operating system into RAM. And when the operating system is loaded into RAM, then everything is controlled by the operating system. Okay, Then operating system takes command of the software system of the computer, or every software, every application software of the computer that will run in that moment or in that system. Okay, so starting the computer, how operating system helps in starting the computer? It follows 5 steps. What are the steps? First, you have to turn on the power button. Then control goes to BIOS. Full form of BIOS is basic input output system that reside on ROM, read only memory. Okay, then what BIOS does? BIOS does a post. What is post? Power on self test. Power on self test means it checks whether the all input and output devices are okay to work properly. Okay, then BIOS sends the control to bootloader. Bootloader is also a program. The purpose of bootloader is to load operating system from hard disk to computer's memory. When the control goes to bootloader finds the boot sector on the disk, and when it finds the boot sector on the disk, it loads the operating system from hard disk to RAM, that is computer's memory. And when the computer's operating system is loaded into computer's memory, everything is controlled by the operating system. Okay, so this is the first one, that operating system helps in starting up the computer. There is another one, process management. And after that, hardware resource management, software resource management, then managing files and folder, and then memory management. In the next video, I will discuss about process management, and in the third video, I will discuss about memory management. So please let me know whether you can understand or not. Okay, you should study the chapter, and if any confusion arises, you must inform me, or you should ask any queries. Okay, so I will come with another video.